some good news for motorists. An oil price rollback looms next week following a five-week streak of price hikes. The Energy Department expects gasoline prices to fall to as much as 1 peso and 20 centavos per liter, while kerosene and diesel may be cheaper by 40 to 65 centavos.
Ang isang balita na naging dahilan sa pagbaba, yung pag-build up ng inventaryo ng United States. Kasi ang ine-expect lang nila mga around 1.89 million, pero tumaas to ng 5.5 million. So ibig sabihin, dumami yung mga stocks. Yung gasolina, yung stockpiles niya bumaba. Pero yung production ng United States tumaas naman. Tsaka ang sabi nga nila, nag-slow yung demand growth. Ibig sabihin, yung ine-expect nating pagtaas ulit ng paggamit ng produktong petrolyo, hindi ganun sa inaasahan. Bumagal siya.
Beginning this Saturday, motorists will be charged to access a newly completed Silang Aguinaldo section of the Cavite Laguna Expressway. That's after the Philippine toll regulator approved the collection of fees in the new section of the expressway. The initial toll rate for Class 1 vehicles is 17 pesos, 35 pesos for Class 2, and 52 pesos for Class 3. The expressway has been open to the public free of charge since November of last year. The Bureau of Internal Revenue setting its sights on a record 3 trillion pesos in tax collections this year. Jackie Pascual tells us how the BIR plans to accomplish that.
It was a music-filled event marking the launch of the 2024 National Tax Campaign of the Bureau of Internal Revenue. Celebrities, social media influencers, and businessmen were among the guests at the gathering where BIR urged everyone to pay taxes on time. BIR Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. says they target to collect 3 trillion pesos this year, much higher than the already record-high tax collection of 2.5 trillion pesos last year.
Gagawin natin lahat ng makakaya natin para makolekta itong 3 trillion na ito. Manawagan sa ating mga taxpayers na magbayad ng tama at magtulungan tayo dahil naman na lahat ng mga ginagawa na ito ay para sa ikaunlad ng bayan.
Lumagi says they will intensify many of their existing programs like the Run After Tax Evaders, revealing that many big-time large taxpayers are under review.
Marami tayong sinusubukan na habulin, nakikipag-coordinate tayo sa kanila kaya naman nauuwi sa kaso ang ibang taxpayers. Nasa 150 na rin yan, malalaking mga taxpayers at sinisigurado natin na ipagpapatuloy natin ang ginagawa nating paghahabol sa mga big-time tax evaders.
It will also strengthen its collection from people earning online, including social media influencers. Lumagi says he understands that many of those earning online may not fully understand the tax payment process, which is why BIR will hold tax awareness events.
Marami sa kanila na hindi lang naman din talaga naiintindihan ang obligasyon nila na nag-resort sa social media tapos bigla na lang kumita na hindi nila alam na kinakailangan magrehistro. Kaya naman pinapaiting natin ang taxpayer information and taxpayer awareness program.
Finance Secretary Ralph Recto for his part says he supports BIR's digitalization efforts. He says improving the economy will help increase revenue collections to fund the national budget of over 5.7 trillion pesos this year.
The DOF will prioritize curbing inflation immediately, keeping prices of goods stable and affordable will ensure continued economic growth, enabling us to boost revenue collection. We are also pushing for the passage of the DOF's refined priority tax measures.
BIR has the highest share of revenue collection target to fund the national budget, followed by the Bureau of Customs and the National Treasury. The government will also need to borrow money to fund the 2024 budget. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Several Philippine senators support a proposal seeking a 100 peso increase in the daily wage of over 4 million workers in the private sector. More from Zen Hernandez.
Despite a 40 peso increase in the daily minimum wage of workers in the National Capital Region last year, company electrician Julius Salas continues to struggle to afford his family's needs. Their food expenses have ballooned to 500 pesos daily, while his transportation allowance rose to 150.
Ang budget mo para lang sa pang-araw-araw.
Kaya, but
Ngayon, halimbawa, sa mga emergency, wala. Umuutang talaga tayo.
Para?
Para yung, halimbawa, sa mga in case of emergency, meron tayong pantapat doon.
After hurdling the committee level, a proposed 100 peso minimum wage hike has finally reached the Senate plenary session. With Senator Jinggoy Estrada, the chairperson for the Senate Committee on Labor, Employment, and Human Resource Development, pushing for its passage. Estrada argues rising prices of basic commodities has significantly eroded the value of the minimum wage, with high inflation expected to persist until 2025.
Bagamat ang inflation ay bumabagal, nasa 2.8% nitong January 2024, hindi ibig sabihin ito ay bumababa na rin ang presyo ng mga bilihin. Sa katunayan, ang rice inflation ay pumalo sa 22.6%, ang pinakamataas na antas mula March of 2009.
Almost all senators supported the proposed bill. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, who originally proposed a 150 peso minimum wage hike, explained that the amount had to be lowered due to the wage hikes issued by regional wage boards since July 2023. He also believes that a 100 peso minimum wage hike is more reasonable since many businesses benefited from the train law.
Ngayon po, sisingilin naman natin ang mga may-ari ng kumpanyang ito dahil binaba po natin ang inyong corporate income tax.
While the National Economic and Development Authority conducts in-depth studies on the impact of wage adjustments to inflation, employment levels, and investments, the Department of Labor and Employment also conducted a simulation that shows a 15 to 25% increase in the operational cost of businesses if a 100 peso minimum wage hike is legislated.
Halimbawa, ang sweldo sa NCR ay ngayon ay 610. Nagdagdag ka ng 100. Okay? Maraming dalampasan yung minimum wage earner at magkakaroon ng tinatawag na wage distortion. Kinakailangan na i-address yun. Ayon sa batas.
But Ibon Foundation says, even with recent adjustments, the prevailing minimum wages are still a far cry from what is considered a living wage for families. A family of five in NCR, for example, needs 1,193 pesos a day in order to afford basic necessities and live decently. But Dole has this to say.
Sa Constitution naman, sinasabi yung living wage din, eh, di ba? Pero sinasabi din sa nasabing provision ng Constitution, yung pagkakataon ng mga investors for a fair return of investment and for growth, no? There is always a balance, no?
Labor groups Tagkaisa and Kilusang Mayo Uno both lauded the Senate and urged the House of Representatives to act speedily on similar proposals instead of focusing on charter change. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.